Check out thechosenprime.com in the link in the description below for this and other great items.
Welcome to another Radio Free Cybertron Review, RFC Reviews. I'm your host, Diecast, and today we have the Soul of Chogokin GX-71 Golion Voltron. Golion in the Asian market, Voltron over here, Defender of the Universe. This is a very special review. Voltron is one of my favorites from when I was a kid, so let's go ahead and take a look at this. So here is Voltron. In the packaging he comes in, you have Soul of Chogokin GX-71 Voltron. Voltron, Defender of the Universe. A nice picture of Voltron on the front, holding the blazing sword. Bandai 2016, made in China. Warning, choking hazard. Tamagotchi, what's that say? Tamagotchi Nations, Bandai, Voltron, Defender of the Universe on the top with a nice picture of the key. That's the only thing we're really missing from this set. I really would have liked to see a nice key or even a roleplay key. That would be awesome. Sorry. And then on the back of the packaging, you have some nice color shots of all their lions, with also their weapons in their mouth, like I omitted. I apologize. The stickers that can go on, the base holding the blazing sword, Voltron with all his pieces. Nice picture of Voltron holding the sword in a pose like you would see on the show. They call it the spinning laser blade. Up top right there. Whoops. Didn't mean to roll in. And then this is also a slipcover, so you take the slipcover off and you have most of the same stuff with the additional UPC code. Some warnings, it's distributed by Bluefin. Thank you, Bluefin, for distributing this. This is a great product. Same thing on the top, you get a picture of Voltron this is the front. On the front, you get a nice picture of Voltron with all the lions soaring or running to their go defeat the evil Robeast. And then there is Golion GX-71. And on the side, you get some lions. And on this side, you get some Voltron. So, and on the bottom, you get some more lions with their weapons in their mouths that, again, I omitted, and I'm sorry. But that is it for the packaging. So let's go ahead and get a look at this guy out of the box. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at the lions. Here they all are in their lion form. We'll go over the red and the yellow, and then the blue and the green are the same as the red and the yellow. So as you can see, yellow lion here. The chrome work on these guys is all really nice. The articulation is absolutely phenomenal. You do have a little bit of a bend here. This is to kind of give them that sitting pose, so they can sit if you want them to, just like that. Just like that. So you can get that sitting pose, which a lot of people wanted. And again, really nice set. I mean, I didn't think I'd like it as much as I do now that I have it in my hands. And it just came today. Luckily, these were still in stock at Big Bad Toy Store. I don't know if they still are or not. They are retail $299. You can also pre-order them from the Chosen Prime. I know they're pre-ordering, but their next delivery is going to be April, which isn't too far off if you think about it. I mean, it's the middle of February right now, so we only have about a month and a half before more of these will be available to everyone. But the head does articulate. You can go side to side. He can go around, and I will show you, the heads do pop off. You can see there's a little hexagon shape right there. That, so if the head does pop off, you can just pop that back in. When you're looking down, there is this little part of the neck. You just kind of want to get that over it like that. And that's about as far down as you'll get. But, again, there is some nice articulation on the heads. And they can, you know, pop their heads off very easily if you want to do that. So for the arms, you can have Voltron missing one of the lion's heads like he just popped it off. Or just shot it off. Sorry. Up here, you do have a rotation for the missile launcher or cannon launcher, whatever you want to call that. The tail is on a little ball joint, so you can rotate that around. And there is a little bit of up and down to that. And then it does flip all the way inside there for transformation purposes, so it can go down about that far. You do have a little swivel at the right there, which will help with ankle tilt, and also for the lion. As you can see, you can get a nice wide stance with him, which I really appreciate and like. The feet, they are on ball joints, or not ball joints, but they can turn from side to side right there. And the back feet are the same way, where they can turn from side to side, and they are a little tight once you use them for the first couple times. They loosen up a little bit. Can also do the scratching behind the ear almost with the one leg. Whoops! Hold your head on, man. As far as the legs, they can go that far forward. They are ratcheted all the way back due to the transformation. And you can see they're on a hinge that will pull out. There's a swivel, and then there's a rocker, and you can kind of push it in a little bit if you don't like it out all the way, but I really do like it out all the way. That's one thing a lot of Voltron toys forget, is that, you know, the arm should actually stick out from the body a little bit. So, and it does help with articulation a ton. Just a really nice figure. Really liking him. Move the camera back just a tad. Yeah. But again, just super, super nice. And then he does have a missile inside his mouth right there. I'm not sure if the missile can actually lift up or not. It doesn't look like it. It looks like it's molded in. Which is, it's okay. That's not preferred for me. I wish it would have been able to lift up, because in Red Lion here, you can see it's actually a separate piece. So it can you can actually aim the missiles forward if you want to. You have the same sort of, and to get his head, to pull his head forward, you kind of almost have to pull it off just to get this extension on the neck done, then just plug it back in. You have to be careful that you don't collapse the neck again. But there you go. That's how far out the neck can go, and then you can get your up and your down, and there is a little bit of side to side just because right in here at the neck joint, that may be on a ball joint or a swivel. So you do get a little bit of side to side with them. Arms are the same articulation. They're on friction joints because these guys are smaller. And his head popped off again. Go on. Just popping off now just because I'm recording. I did not have this problem earlier. Again, you do have missiles on him. And then the, like I said, the legs are on friction instead of ratchets just because the way the arms are much smaller. But he does have ratchet in the waist, which is nice. And then there is an extra joint right here for this piece, so you can get extra articulation out of that, which also helps with side to side if you want to do any side to side. And we'll just rotate that around. I know there's a way to do that. Yeah, you would rotate there. So you can kind of get him going around corners. That also helps with the articulation for Voltron himself. And then the paws do have that same side-to-side motion on that little hinge there. So these guys, I mean, I can't complain at all about the articulation on these guys. It's really, really nice. And his tail popped off. Because, again, we're shooting a review. So, you know, that's necessary. And then the tail is on a ball joint, so you can get a little wiggly, wiggly-waggly. That was got stuck. You can get a little up and a little down. But he can't quite put his tail between his legs just because it doesn't bend that way. Don't lose your head, man. But, there you go. There's Red Lion. And then we'll just take a quick look at green and blue. Same articulation as the other two. You do have a missile up here for green. A little bit different. I like that each, you know, body, even the legs are different. They have different slots, different. Green's head isn't popping off as much as red is. You do get a little bit of the side to side on him, just like red. You have the missiles in there, really nice kind of goldish yellow eyes. And here you have the bottom of the figure, same type of articulation, just really, really nice. Really solid figures and really heavy. Like, the arms are not that heavy. Black Lion feels like it's almost all die cast. It's just a lot of heft to him, even though he's not that big. Blue Lion, really nice head sculpt. You can put the optional letters on these guys if you want. Pop this up. There's Blue Lion's missiles, and nothing too different about Blue Lion here, so, but, just realized there's a button there for Blue Lion, too. I'm not sure what that does. I'm sure it does something. There's a button on the bottom, and I think that's to help release the legs, or to push the legs in, or to help, you know, collapse the legs inside, either one. So we'll put Blue Lion away, take a look at Black Lion. Now, a lot of the pictures have the waist kind of collapsed, and even the legs kind of rotated. So he's actually a smaller lion. He just comes off stubby this way to me. So what I like to do is extend the waist and kind of rotate the hips all the way back. That way his tail is out as far as it can. And it just kind of lengthens him overall. And to me, makes a much better looking lion. Again, articulation on this guy, his legs can go all the way back. They can go forward about that much. You do have, like I said, this rotation up here. Legs can go forward that far, backward that far. But, you do have these feet on him are on ball pegs, so you can get a full 360 on the foot and even ratchet it up and down. Really nice, really nice. The legs can rotate right here. A lot of this, you know, we're going through is going to be the same articulation for Voltron, just because he is the center bot, but figure go over it here. Legs, you get a nice outward movement, so he can again rotate a little bit at the waist right here, the waist of Voltron, and you do get a pretty nice ab crunch out of it also. And then on the front side, you can get a full 360. Legs can go forward that much and go backward that much. And then again, his front paws are on a ball peg, so you can get the full rotation, nice ratcheted joint on the paws, which again, I think on this figure is needed because he is so heavy. You can get pretty good down on the neck. You can get a full 360, which is a little weird. A little exorcism going on there. You can get a side to side, and you can get up about that far. When mine came, it was all pushed in, and that doesn't give you a lot of articulation, so I think that is for the robot mode, and this is for Lion. And again, the more you stretch this figure out because of the size of him, I think the better off he looks. You can angle these wings however you want. I just prefer to keep them together. They do stick up a little bit. I wish they could have came down and laid on his back a little bit better. But it's not horrible. And again, this is the first Black Lion I think I've ever had where I went to open the mouth and the whole Voltron face didn't come down. So I really appreciate that. That's a really nice touch. The teeth are ridiculously sharp on all these guys. So definitely recommend, you know, using some caution when you're opening and closing the mouths on these guys. His tail is on a ball joint, just like the other ones. And then you have a hinge here. And it goes down about that far. So that's about as far down as the tail on the tail you can get it. But, yeah, these are amazing lions. Just absolutely incredible. Get them kind of posed in there. They're just can't even say enough about how great these lions are. which is probably why they're sold out everywhere, because I had such a hard time finding them. And again, I just wanted to mention, which I think I forgot I was going there, but I originally ordered these guys from AnimePoko, POKO.com, because they were like $55 cheaper, $56 cheaper, something like that, than anywhere else. But after the ship date came and went, I tried contacting them through their customer service twice. It's been over 3 weeks now that I sent at least the first one, and I sent two more after that. Got no responses, and then I started reading online that, you know, a lot of people, they pre-order, they order something and they list it as a pre-order or a back order, and it never comes in. And after so many months, you lose the protection from your credit card. So luckily, I was able to contact my credit card and say, you know, this is fraudulent. They haven't sent the merchandise. They haven't contacted me. I've contacted them with no response. So now my credit card issued me the money back, but it's under investigation. So I've seen some people say that they still could take the money anyway, even though they give it back to me for now. But just be aware, don't buy from AnimePoko on anything. I wouldn't trust them. It looked like they were out of California, if I remember properly, but don't buy from them, just as a warning. So let's go ahead and get these guys ready to be in the combined form. Actually, before we do that, I'm going to take a quick break. I'm going to armor these guys all up so you guys can take a quick look at that. All right, so here you have the whole team weaponed up, and you can see the guns and missiles. They all plug into the front arms. They all rotate so you can spin them if you want, depending on how you're posing the legs. They're all done really nice, and they only fit in one individual figure each. I was trying to plug yellow lions in the green lions, and it looks like the slots are the same, but they are, green lions are a little bit smaller, so you just want to be careful that, like I say, even these, they do spin, so you can pose them however you want. Green lion, I forgot to flip up his missile right here at the center, so he has the extra one, same as red. Let's look at red or black. You get the ones that plug into the shoulders right there. They are the only ones that don't rotate, but they do rotate when they're clicked in. Red lion, same thing. Again, these weapons are all done really nice. Just absolutely incredible. And then there's blue lion. And now let's go ahead and we'll get the weapons off these guys and we'll get them transformed. All right, now that we got all these guys de-armed, let's go ahead and go into transformation. On the blue line, you just want to compress everything. Get these legs in place. Just like that. Rotate the head forward. And then there is a little extra stabilizer here that you can bring back. That'll help support the figure. And then you kind of want it just like that. Then you can collapse. I'm not sure what actually holds those legs in, but at some point you can collapse them. And then obviously the back legs, they kind of already collapse themselves. Close up the tail. There you have one foot already done. hopefully got this stable enough. And we'll come over to the yellow line, which is basically the same thing. Squeeze the legs in, collapse them up. Same thing on this. Rotate the head up. Just get that out of the way. Rotate the legs. Make sure everything's nice and straight. And then you can see those black cylinders just compressed in. And then we'll flip out this heel spur. And that'll help you kind of line everything up. You can either have it like that, or you can maybe one. It's going to be whatever feels good to you. And you can use the legs for a little bit of extra stability right there if you put the feet down. Otherwise, they're going to be up like this. So just bring the leg down a little bit and straighten out the foot. That'll give you a better base for your Voltron. And let's go ahead, we'll raise the camera up. And we'll come to Green Lion, close up his missile, collapse the legs, collapse the and his tail popped off again. It's just a matter of getting the feet how you like them. Which I think for me, right there is pretty good. You can see there is a little cutout for the foot to sit in. So have that on both sides. Legs are already collapsed. There's another arm. All done. Push the head in. It's already pushed in. Same thing on red. Collapse that up. Collapse that up. Make sure the legs are pressed in. And then you can bring these down to plug into Voltron. There you go. Now we'll come up to the Black Lion. We'll collapse his tail. Collapse it, just fold it up onto the back. Bring the legs up. Bring these down. So they're straight. Now what you want to do on the legs, you want to flip out this back piece right there. And then flip this panel in. That'll give you room for the legs to fit in. And we'll do that on blue. And you hear it click in there. That locks the leg in real nice. Press it to take it apart. There's a button on here. You just want to press that. Also may help if you press that when you're putting the leg in. So do the same thing on yellow. Gonna open up this back panel. Push that down. We'll press on the button on the back. You can see the piece inside there. That'll move when I press it. Get that all pressed in. Then you can close up that panel on the back there. That gives it that clean look. I'll come up to the waist. I'm going to collapse his waist. You can, if you choose, leave it uncollapsed. Uncollapsed. Maybe not collapsed would be a better word. Come up to the top here. First thing we're going to do is open up these panels on the arms. Come on. Open up. Fold the legs in. Get these front legs in. Close them up. Then we're going to bring them around. There you can see. Oh, that is one piece of articulation I missed. These will arms will also pull out just like the other lions. Then we're going to take Green Lion. Push him in. He'll clip in real nice. Red Lion, same thing. Really nice. Holds together. Collapse the neck all the way down into the base, and then we can form the head, which is just taking it out and collapsing the neck basically. And we'll flip open the ears. And there you have Voltron in his robot mode. And this Voltron is really nice. Really, really nice. And they don't have a ratchet at the waist. They're just friction at the legs. So you can get whatever ace stance you want, which I really appreciate. That's really, really nice. I feel like we should do the Voltron as he comes down from combining. And then you should see the Robeast just basically lose their mind. Really nice. I'm noticing right now, this is the first time I've had Voltron together, so you guys are getting my honest opinion on this. Because of that articulation in the back, that acts as an extra ab crunch. So even without extending the ab, you can get him looking down that much. Really impressive. Really, really nice. You can get his legs out that far, which I feel is a fine amount. His legs are kind of heavy, so he will sink down. But as far as A stances go, you can get really wide pose with him. Super, super nice. The articulation on the arms. You got a ratchet right here. Do have to make sure these shoulders don't rotate. That way they stay together. Would have been nice if there would have been a way. Ah, there is a way. Right up here, if you slide these little pieces over, just like that, that'll lock in the arms. So when you rotate, these pieces won't rotate. And that's really nice. Looks like they should slide over more, but they just slide over like a half. Nope, they do lock in. Just gotta do it on this side. There we go. And they lock in. So that holds this section together up top. So you can rotate the arms. And it's not going to rotate these legs. That's really nice. That is amazing. This figure is absolutely amazing. This is the Voltron I've always wanted. And it's not that small. Let's rotate these wings up too. Because what is Voltron without his wings? There you go. You can see nice look on the back. On the front, here he is with Titans Return. Oh no, that's not Titans Return. Legends, Takara, Optimus Prime. So he is much larger than a leader class figure in size. The arms, the articulation on the arms is great. You can get a full, you can get more than 90 degrees on the arm, which is, you know, just, oh, he's so nice. So happy I had this figure. So happy Big Bad Toy Store still had it in stock that I was able to get it now instead of waiting until April. But honestly, if you have to wait to April, you don't have the money for it now, but you want to get it, I mean, this is certainly worth waiting for or saving up for. You can extend the waist if you want. This is why I kind of like that extended in lion mode as opposed to robot mode. I'm not a fan of it in robot mode, and he's still got plenty of articulation up and back and even side to side without that being extended up. So let's go ahead, try and straighten him up. Because what I want to do is do a size comparison with some older Voltron figures. Here he is with the new Voltron. The Netflix Voltron, as I call him. So you can get a size comparison on them. Bring the camera back. And again, obviously, I mean, the Netflix Voltron is ridiculously huge. Which is okay, I'm not complaining, but I didn't think the Soul Chogokin Voltron had to be that big. Here he is with another Voltron I had laying around. I don't know what year I got this. He tends to lean forward a little bit. He's a leaner. Not a wiener. I said leaner. I'm doing a clean review today, as I usually do. But, you know, if some of you watch RFC when we're doing the extra, you know, the pre-show or the post-show, it can get a little off color. But there you have it. They're pretty much the same height, and you can see crappy Voltron, really nice Voltron I always wanted. Crappy Voltron, really nice Voltron I always wanted. But yeah, I probably have a couple other Voltrons, but they're not out, so this is the best one. So it's a normal Voltron scale for me, and I think it really fits in. Well, it doesn't fit in. It kills everything else. I just noticed the gold in the shield or the crest on the front. It's just really, really nice detail. Face is really nice. He also comes with an additional yelling face right there that you can swap out if you choose. And we'll get this Voltron out of the way. Alright, so two little added features or things that I missed that I just wanted to throw in here real quick is to change the head, or the face I should say. Flip in the ears, rotate the head up, and then what you can do is you can just slide the face right down. And then I don't have the other face next to me. Well, that face fell. I might as well get it. You can slide on the new face, push the head down, flip out the ears, and there you have the alternate face. So, pretty easy peasy, no screws. I like that on a face swap. And the second thing here with Voltron is on the back, the tail will actually lock everything in to place. That way this joint now locks in. You can see there is a tab inside there, which will clip in right there. Then if you push the tail in, it'll lock everything together. And then just because of this nub, you kind of do have to... I like to sit it right above. It gives it a little bit of bend, but not enough that you actually notice it from the front. Just like that. Because if you pop the tail out, and you have that behind it, it'll keep pushing the tail out and unclipping, so it's kind of got to be above that lock point right there. Now, altogether, he is really heavy. He is a solid figure. Highly recommend this figure. I can't recommend him enough. If you're a Voltron fan, you really should be picking this up. He is just amazing. He's actually so good. He's making me rethink my thoughts of skipping out on the original Megazord that is coming out from the Soul Chikokin line, because, God, if he's as nice as him, he's probably a must-have. So, let's go ahead. Before I go in, I wanted to show you the plastic containers. These are what the weapons come in. And there are two swords. One fell out, of course. But they come in nice plastic containers for the weapons. Ooh, earthquake. Then they also have a plastic container for the base, which we're going to build right now. And for the lions and some of the other extra weapons, they are in styrofoam with plastic on top, and then these plastic trays are laid on top of that in the box. So you have some really nice, speaking of things I forgot, there's all these weapons that the lions can hold in their mouth, and they do hold in very solid. But just to show those off, sorry, I did forget to do that earlier. And then here is his sword, which again has really nice detail on this thing. Really nice paint applications. The chrome is excellent. I don't see any flaws in any of the chrome. The only flaw is when I touch it, I get fingerprints all over it. But, and then we'll plug him into Red Lion. And they just tab in. And again, really, really nice. So here's all the pieces for the base, and we're just going to build these real quick. Again, actually, we'll probably clip these sides on first. And these are supposed to represent or look like castles from the planet Eris. You can clip that on just like that. And there you have your stand. And here is a shelf for some of the weapons, and I'll come back, we'll get this all armored up. So here is the stand with all the weapons on it, including the mouth weapons, which I forgot to show off while we were in vehicle mode, while we're in lion mode. And there are two front plates that you can put on, the Go Lion plate or the Voltron plate. Of course, because I am in the US, I'm going to put on the Voltron plate. And that just clips on right there. to finish out your stand and make that look very nice. And then, as you can see on the back, the sides, the weapons go, the shelf, the extra face goes in there, his little shield. Here is the other side with the other weapons on it. This is also the handle for the shield. And then, like I said, this tray completely comes out to give you better access to that and the face. And then on the top right here, swords can slide out pretty easy. Not when it's sitting, but... And on the top right here, you can take the blazing sword and just... Not sure which way this goes, but it will slot in. You can place it however you want. And again, really, 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 really love this set. And so happy that I have it. Again, Voltron just looks absolutely amazing. Do another quick size comparison before we go. There he is with MP10. Just for a size comparison on those guys.